Back at the shop, it's almost bath time.
So we have a plan. We have the pool, we have the scale, and we have our little Klaus. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna weigh him normally, then we're gonna give him a bath.
Getting his dry weight of 19.4 pounds is the easy part. Now it's time to get wet.
Oh, no, 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 not too high, not too high.
Okay.
Just right on him. Right there.
There we go.
With 8 dogs at home, Rachel's got bath time down pat.
Oh.
Elijah, not so much.
Yeah, I have no dogs, I'm a cat person. Well, I like cats, I'm not furry.
Every fiber of this furry frame wants to shimmy from nose to tail.
The hardest part was not getting the dogs to shake, because that's all they want to do is shake.
Elijah grabs a reading of 20.4 pounds. Not a second too soon.
That was all up in my face.
Then it's back on the scale for those vital post-shake particulars.
20.1 pounds.
Yay! Good boy, Klaus.
0.3 of a pound doesn't sound like much, but math genius and college sophomore Cannan soon confirms that the myth is off to a promising start.
The results are that Klaus lost about 60% of his water weight in one shake cycle.
It's not 70%, but it's still very impressive.
Impressive enough for Elijah to propose his pet theory of comparative species shaking.
We're gonna test to see if humans can shake water out of their hair just like dogs can shake water out of their fur.
No prizes for guessing which human. Just like Klaus, Elijah first gets weighed dry, then it's stunk time.
In 3, 2, 1, go, down. Thank you. Oh, that was fun.
Go.
Oh.
Elijah's now weighed with his mane wringing wet. And then.
Oh my. Oh. Elijah. Elijah.
So let's get the data on dude versus dog.
I gained 0.7 pounds after my hair was soaked, and I lost 0.2 pounds when I shook out my hair.
Okay. Math man, what is that in percentage?
That is 28.5% of the water lost.
Not too shabby. Still no match for Klaus. But to give this myth a fair shake, they'll need a much bigger sample size.